in this question again it has been told that we have to solve it by the first principle. So first step is going to be same, we have to put it equal to y. Then the second step is we have to just add the increments. So if we add the increment on the left hand side, it will be y plus delta y, and on the right hand side it will be x plus delta x minus 2. So now we cannot solve it further. Maximum we can open out this bracket. So just keep putting it as equation number 2. Now 2 minus 1, as we have done in all the steps. So on the left hand side it will be y plus delta y minus y, and on the right hand side it will be 3x plus delta x minus 2 minus 3x minus 2. So this is the case of under root. So here our target should be to remove these under roots so that we can solve the question quite easily. So how this under root can be cancelled? By squaring it out. So how can we maximum square it? So what we can do is we can apply the method of rationalization over here. If we apply the method of rationalization, we still can solve it. So before proceeding with the next step, let us try to just remove these under roots. So rationalization is what? It is multiplying and dividing with the same figure. So if this is our question, I have just copied it down below. So here, applying the rationalization process, I am going to copy this entire same 3x plus delta x minus 2, only this sign I am going to change, and I am going to divide it with the same thing. So with this, if I divide and multiply with the same thing, I'm dividing and multiplying this part with the same thing. So if I cancel it, it will be 1. But my task is, because signs are opposite, so here I will just apply the formula A minus B, and this will become A plus B. And you all know A minus B and A plus B is A square minus B square. So above you can see in the numerator, this is my A, this is my B, this is the A, this is the B. So here it will be converted into A square minus B square. By squaring it, the under root will be cancelled. So let us see how it can be solved. So on the left hand side we have delta y, and now after applying this formula, it will be 3x plus delta x minus 2 minus under root 3x minus 2. These both will be squared, and in the denominator the same will be left, 3x plus delta x minus 2 plus 3x minus 2 in the under root. So this is we are left with. So now this will be deleted. This square is going to delete this under root. So what we are left with now? So here our delta y is equal to 3. If I open this bracket, 3x plus 3 delta x minus 2. Here it will be minus 3x plus 2. Divided by the denominator is same, 3x plus delta x minus 2 plus 3x minus 2. So this is what we are getting. So here you can see this plus 3x and minus 3x, it can be deleted. Plus 2 minus 2 can be deleted. So what is left? Delta y is equals to 3 delta x divided by the same denominator, 3x plus delta x minus 2 plus 3x minus 2. So now our next step is dividing both the sides with delta x. if we divide the left hand side with delta x, we will be getting delta y upon delta x, and on the right hand side, if we divide this by delta x, this delta x will be deleted. So the result is this: x plus delta x minus 2 plus 3x minus 2. So finally, we will put up our last step. Our last step was taking the limit. If we take limit over here, it will be converted into the differentiation, that is dy upon dx. And here, if I take my denominator, in the denominator, if I take delta x to be equal to 0, it will be x plus 0 minus 2 plus 3x minus 2. So if you open this bracket again, it will be in the denominator here, it will be 3x minus 2. On the right hand side also, it will be 3x minus 2. And in the middle, there is plus sign, right? So here it will be 3x minus 2. Sign will be of plus in between. So now you can see that on the both hand sides, you will be having the same figures, 3x minus 2, 3x minus 2. So we can write here is 2, 3x minus 2, because two things are being added. So the answer is 3 by 2, and in the denominator along with under root 3x minus 2.